Hello everyone, I am Trupti Pandya and today I will be teaching you Element of Account Standard 11 Part 1 Chapter 6 Subsidiary Book. In previous lecture we already completed the sales book. Of two type of sales book is there. One is one column of goods is there, then simple sales book is there. More than one type of goods are there, then columnar sales book is there. And now third type today, let us start the third type of sales book. This is goods and expense column is there. With the goods there is a expense column is also there. This type of a sales book we have to prepare. Let us start it. Sales book with column for goods and expense. When a businessman sells goods on credit, many a times other charges are to be recovered from purchaser. Purchaser means customer. Part from the sales value of goods. Normally such charges are in respect of GST, railway freight, carriage, packing charges, etc. Out of such amounts charged to customers, certain charges are such as GST payable to government, whereas other expenses are incurred on behalf of customers and here are to be recovered from them. To obtain information of each such a different expenses, a sales book with columns for goods and expenses is prepared. Many times sales invoice is prepared by adding such charges. When the sales is there at that time, some charges, some expenses are also included in this. Charges recovered as per sales book are credited to respective charges and these accounts are debited when such charges are actually paid by the firm. For example, when GST is added in a sales invoice, the amount of GST is credited to sales tax payable account. When this amount is paid to government, GST account shall be debited. In sales book with columns for expenses, the amount column is divided into more than one column and separate column is kept for each such expense. For the expenses, we have to keep the separate column for this. Specimen of sales book with expense column is as under. Sales book of 3, here we have to write the businessman's name, trader's name, date, name of customer, outward invoice number, laser folio number, date, amount of goods, railway freight, labor, intrastate supply, means in one state there is a sales is there, input CGST and input SGST. Interstate, another state supply is there, at that time IGST is there, total amount. From the specimen of a sales book, it can be observed that all information is similar to simple sales book. Only column of amount are categorized. For each expense, separate column is kept. Total amount of each expense can be ascertained from it. In ledger for all above stated accounts, account will be opened and positions will be done. All respective accounts will be credited. Illustration number 6. From the following transactions, prepare sales book inclusive of expenses in the books of Sardar Stores of Surat. Sardar Stores kept record of GST, railway freight and labor. Prepare sales book on the basis of total GST rate 12%. GST is not included for following transaction. Add applicable amount of GST and prepare sales book. Here 12% is given, means CGST and SGST 66% is there. Now 2015 June, goods sold of rupees 30,000, 10% trade discount. Pankaj 30,000, 10% trade discounts means 30,000, 10% means 3,000 is there. 30,000 minus 3,000, then 27,000 rupees is there. Railway freight 1,000 and wages 300, invoice number 123. Goods sold rupees 50,000, 10% trade discount on cash. When on cash word is there, it is a cash transaction, so we not write this transaction. Goods sold of rupees 20,000, 5% trade discount on credit, 3 months of Jayesbhai of Jaipur, Rajasthan. Another state is there. On behalf of Jayesbhai, paid labor 250 and railway freight 400. Invoice number 130 sent by adding labor and railway freight. Now, 15 date, a old machine. Asset sold. So this transaction also we not write because machine is an asset and when asset sold we have to not write this transaction in our sales book. Goods sold of date number 25. Goods sold of rupees 10,000, 5% trade discount on credit for 3 months to Vaibhavi railway freight was ₹800. Vaibhavi paid half amount, total amount invoice number 135. Half amount paid. But half transaction is when cash transaction and half transaction is credit transaction. Then we write full transaction here in our sales book. Goods sold of ₹40,000, 10% trade discount on credit 1 month. Gaurang. Railway freight 1500 added in invoice number 140 and sent in. Now sales book of Sardar Stores. Here date, name of customer, outward invoice number, laser folio number, net amount of goods, railway freight, labor, intrastate supply, output CGST, output SGST and interstate supply IGST. Output means when we sold the goods, it is output, and so we have to use output CGST and output is SGST. Interstate supply is there, then we have to use IGST. Total amount is there. 2019 June 1st, Pankaj account, invoice number is outward invoice number 123. And net amount 30,000, 10% trade discount minus then 27,000 is there. Railway 5,000 and labor 300. Output GST 6% is there. So 1,698. And output SGST 6%, 28,300, 6%, then 1,698 and 1,698. We add these all the columns, then we get 31,696. Jayesh Bhai account, invoice number 130, 19,000 rupees, 400 railway freight, 250 labor. Total, this is the another state, so 12% is there, 19,650, 12%, then 2,358 rupees is there. When we add all the, sum of all the right, total amount 22,008 is there. Date number 25, Vaibhavi account. Outward invoice number 135, net amount of goods 9,500, railway freight 800, 9,500 plus 800, then it is 10,300. And on 10,300 6%, then 618 rupees output CGST and 618 rupees output SGST is there. And total of all the column is 11,536. Date number 30, Gaurang account, outward invoice number 140, total net amount of goods 36,000, railway freight 1500, output CGST 2250, output SGST 2250, 36,000 and 1500, 37,500 and 37,500 6% means 2250 rupees is there, and total of all the column is 42,000. Now, net amount of goods, total of 27,000, 19,000, 9,500 and 36,000, then it is 91,500. Railway freight, total amount 3,700. Labor, 550. Output CGST, 4,566. Output SGST also 4,566. Interstate supply IGST, 2,358. And total of all the goods and expenses is 1,07,240. Following transactions will not be recorded in sales book. Date number 10, cash sales will be recorded in cash book. Date number 15, machine asset is sold on credit will be recorded in journal proper and labor will be recorded in cash book. Transaction off of 25th where Vaibhavi has paid 5,387.50 will be recorded in cash book. The net amount of sales recorded in the sales book and GST are calculated as follows. Net amount of goods is 27,000, railway freight 1,000, labor 300, total 28,300. And GST calculation is CGST 6%, SGST 6%, 1,698. On 28,300, 6%, then 1,698, CGST, SGST same. Now, IGST for 10,300, 12% is there. So we have to write 10,300 and 37,500, 12%, 2,250 rupees is there. Now interest rate supply is there, 10,300. Here IGST is 6,680. Third subsidiary book now. purchase return book. When we purchase the good and if it is inferior quality goods are there or not as per the given order, at that time we have to return this good. It is called the purchase return. And when we prepare the book for this type of goods, it is called purchase return book. Two types of return books, purchase return book and sales return book is there. Generally, goods once purchased are returned under the following circumstances. First, when the goods are not as per the sample. When goods are inferior quality goods are there. Third, when goods are in damaged condition. Fourth, to get rebate or refund by returning container or packing of the goods. Fifth, goods are not delivered at a time. Sixth, goods returned for any other reason. When goods purchased on credit are returned for any of the above stated reason, such returns are recorded in the purchase return book. Only those purchase return transactions where cash is not received or paid are recorded in purchase return book. It means when there is a credit purchase is there and we return the goods, at that time we have to write this type of transaction in our purchase return book. Following journal entries will be passed. Supplier means trader account debit to purchase return account. Here, supplier means trader is the receiver and goods goes from our business unit. When goods goes from our business unit, goods are credited. So, our purchase reduced. So, to purchase account. And here, supplier trader is the receiver. So, as per the personal rule, receive debit the receiver. So, we have to write the trader's account debit to purchase return account. In the above journal, trader's account, individual account is debited. So, while returning the goods, debit note is sent. When the trader receives the goods, he sends the credit note. Purchase return book can be mainly prepared in two ways. Purchase return, simple purchase return book and columnar purchase return book. Purchase return book with column according to types of goods. And purchase return book with column of goods and expenses. The specimen of a purchase return book, simple purchase return book for only one type of good is there. Purchase return book of three, here we have to write the trader's name, date, name of supplier, debit note number, laser folio number and amount. Here we have to write the total. Afterward, columnar purchase return book. Columnar purchase return book according to type of goods. Purchase return book of three, here we write the trader's or businessman's name, date, name of supplier, debit note number, laser folio number, amount rupees, table, chair, cupboard and total amount. Here we have to write the total. Now, third, specimen of a purchase return book with goods and expenses, date, name of supplier, debit note number, laser folio number. Net amount of goods, railway freight, labor, intrastate supply, means input CGST, input SGST. Purchase return is there, so we have to write here input CGST and input SGST. Interstate supply IGST and afterward total. Generally, purchase return book is maintained exactly as the purchase book is maintained. Simple purchase return book is maintained when purchase book is simple. In the same way, if the purchase book is with column for different type of goods or goods and expense, the purchase return book will also be maintained with different column for types of goods or goods and expense. Number of column are kept in purchase return book are same as the number of column in the purchase book. First, it is date. In above specimen, first column is of date. The date on which goods are written is shown here. Second, name of supplier. In this column, name of the supplier to whom the goods are returned and detail of goods written are entered. Third, debit note number. The number of debit notes sent along with goods returned is recorded here. Fourth one, laser folio number. The page number of laser on which the amount is debited in the account of a concerned supplier is recorded in this column. Amount. Amount of net purchase return is recorded in this column. Debit note. When the goods purchased on credit are returned to the supplier, the note sent to the supplier to claim rebate for the returned goods is known as a debit note. while returning goods a letter or note is sent along with the return goods showing the amount which is debited to supplier's account. Such note is known as a debit note. The following details are shown in debit note. First, name and address of supplier to whom the goods are returned. Debit note number and date. Full particulars of goods returned. Net amount of goods returned. The reason for return of goods or debit note. Debit note is prepared in the following circumstances. First, debit note is prepared while returning the purchased goods which are not as per the sample are in inferior quality or damaged. When the invoice received is for more amount than the amount of actual goods purchased, or when the quantity shown in invoice is more than the actual quantity of goods received. If more amount are credited to supplier's account due to the error calculation at the time of accounting. Debit note is also prepared when the amount of empty bags for container return is to be recovered. Debit note is also prepared when discount is received from the trader. Now, what is the debit note? Specimen of debit note. First of all, heading debit note. Sri Patel Trading Company, dealer of chocolate. Here address, invoice number is debit note number is given 108, 16 Sriji Complex, Vashna, Ahmedabad 380007. Sri Sivam Traders account. Date 2015 March 7. 10 chocolate boxes returned due to the inferior quality, each box of rupees 2000. 2000 into 10, 20,000 rupees total amount. E and OE, error and omission accepted. For Patel Trading Company, signature partner. Now, sales return book. An enterprise records the transaction of goods return in sales return book. If the goods sold on credit are returned by its customer, generally goods once sold are returned under the same circumstances of a purchase return. When goods sold on credit are returned for any reason, the customer sends a debit note along with the returned goods. Similarly, the enterprise receiving back the returned good issue credit note when it receives such goods and send the same to the customer. Only those sales return transactions where cash is not received or paid are recorded in sales return book. In sales return book, when there is a credit transaction is there and when we sold the credit, at that time we have to write this transaction in our sales book. But this credit sales transactions are there and these goods are returned back to our back to the trader. At that time we have to write this type of transaction in a sales return book. Sales return book, two types are there, simple sales return book and columnar sales return book. In columnar sales book return is also two parts are there, columnar sales return book according types of goods and columnar sales return book according to goods and expense. Now, specimen of a sales return book, simple sales return book for only one type of goods. Sales return book of three, here we have to write the trader name, date, name of customer, credit note number, laser folio, amount and total. Columnar sales return book. Sales return book record according to type of goods. More than one type of goods is there. Date, name of customer. Here we have to write sales return book of 3 year, name of the trader. Credit note number, laser folio number, table, chair, cupboard and total amount is there. Now, sales return book with goods and expenses column. Here sales return book of 3, trader's name we have to write, date, name of supplier, invoice number, ledger folio number, net amount of goods, railway freight, labor, intrastate supply, output CGST, output SGST and interstate supply, IGST, total amount. Generally, when simple sales book is maintained, the sales return book also would be simple. Similarly, when columnar sales book according to type of goods of columns with expenses maintained, the returns book is also would be columnar. First column, date. The date on which goods are returned is shown in this column. Name of customer, name of the customer who has returned the goods and details of goods returned are entered in this column. Credit note. the number of credit not sent, return of goods is recorded in this column, ledger folio number. The page number of the ledger on which the amount is credited in the account of a concerned customer is recorded in this column. Amount of net sales is recorded in this column. So it is very simple. Whenever we write date, name of customer, credit note, ledger folio number, and afterward total amount. When sales written book is maintained with columns for expenses, proportionate rebate of GST, carriage, railway freight, etc. will also be claimed by customer in respect of written goods. Such amount of rebate is shown in the respective column. For a sales written book, total amount of a sales written is determined. For this purpose, enterprise can maintain sales written book for a fixed convenient period, like weekly, fortnightly. Weekly means 1 week, is fortnight means 15 days, monthly, quarterly means 3 months, half yearly means 6 months, or yearly means 12 months. The period depends upon the need of information, convenience, and the method of preparing sales book. Now, what is the credit note? Credit note is an important document related to sales written book. When the goods sold on credit are written by the customer, the proportionate amount for the written good is credited to the account of such a customer. A note sent to the customer confirming such a credit is known as a credit note. Whenever a businessman sells goods on credit, he debits the customer account and credit the sales account. Now, when any of the said goods are written by the customer, the proportionate amount of goods written is credited to the respective customer's account. Similarly, while intimating of the customers about credit to his account in respect of written goods, a letter or note is sent showing the amount which is credited to his account. Such note is known as a credit note. Following details are shown in the credit note. First, name and address of customer who has written the goods. Second, credit note number and date. Third, full particular of a goods return. Fourth, net amount of goods return. Fifth, the reason for return of goods or credit note. Specimen of credit note. Credit note. Credit note number 223. Sri Sivam Traders. Traders of chocolate, Sri Patel Trading Company. Here address is given, 7 Sri Hari Building, Navrangpura, Ahmedabad, 38009. Date 2015 March 7. Today received back 10 chocolate boxes of rupees 2000 each. So 2000 into 10, total amount is 20,000. E and OA for Sivam Traders, signature manager. So this way, credit note is completed. Credit note is prepared in the following circumstances: when customer returns goods out of credit sales made, when the invoice is sent for more amount than the amount of actual goods sold, if any error in the calculation at the time of accounting, if any type of rebate is given to the customer, rebate for empty bags or containers returned by customer. It can be seen in the above specimens of a debit note and credit note. Patel Trading Company had sent debit note while returning the goods, and Sivam Traders had sent credit note after the said goods received. It can be seen that the amount of both notes is the same. Now, illustration number 7. From the following transactions, prepare purchase book, sales book, purchase return book, and sales return book in the book of Sri Hasmukh Bhai. 2015 January 1st date, purchased goods of rupees 10,000 from Dhruvil at 10% trade discount, bill number 110. 10,000, 10% means 1,000, total 9,000 is there. Purchased goods of rupees 4,000 from Komal at 10% cash discount, credit 2 months. Here cash discount word is there, it means this is the cash transaction, so we not write anywhere. Sold goods of rupees 8,000 to Sajjan, 5% trade discount, 2% cash discount, invoice number 90. Purchased goods of rupees 4,000 cash memo number, so it is also cash transaction. Goods of rupees 2,000 retained by Sajjan for which credit note 15 was sent. Goods of rupees 2,000 returned by Sajjan. This is the books of Hasmukh Bhai, and Hasmukh Bhai sold the Sajan, and now this is sales return is there. 10% goods returned to Dhruvil, purchase return is there, and debit note number 16 sent to him. Purchased furniture, asset purchase. So this transaction is not right anywhere in our subsidiary book. Purchased the goods of rupees 30,000 from Nirmi and have the amount paid immediately. This is also right in a purchase book. The entire goods purchased from Nirmi sold to Haley for 36,000, 10% trade discount, invoice number 100, credit period 3 months. Haley returned half the goods sold her and same were returned to Nirmi. Kanu placed an order. This transaction also not come because place an order is there. Supplied goods of rupees Kanu for his order. 300 added for the labor invoice 102. 25 date cash purchase rupees 20,000 and cash sales 25,000. Cash is there, so this transaction also not right anywhere in our subsidiary book. Kanu returned half of the goods sold to him and it was agreed to give a rebate of a carriage in proportionate. Now first of all we purchase prepare the purchase book and all the purchase transaction we have to write in our purchase book. Name of date, name of supplier, inward invoice number, laser folio number and amount. 2015 January 1, Dhruvil account 110, inward invoice number, total amount 9000, date 3, Komal account 4000 rupees and date 8, Nirmi account 30,000. Means total purchase, credit purchase is 43,000. Now, sales book of Sri Hasmukh Bhai. 2015 January 7, sold to Sajan, it is customer name and outward invoice number 90. Amount 7,600. 19 Haley account 100 invoice number and 32,400. Kanu account goods 10,800. So we have to write here 10,800 and total sales is 50,800. Now purchase return book of Sri Hasmukh Bhai. 2015 January 15 Dhruvil account debit note number 16 and amount 900. And date number 20 Nirmi account 15,000 rupees. Total purchase return is 15,900. And sales return book of Sri Hasmukh Bhai. Date 2015 January 11. Name of customer Sajan. Credit note number 15. Amount 2000. 20 Haley account 16,200. And 31 Kanu account goods of rupees 5,400. Total amount is 23,600. The amount transaction shall not be recorded. Date number 10, cash purchase transactions will recorded in cash book. Date number 16, purchase of fixed asset. This will be recorded in journal proper. Date number 21, non-financial transactions. This will not be recorded. Date number 24, 300 will be recorded in cash book. Date number 25, cash purchase and cash sales transactions will be recorded in cash book. Date January 15, 10% goods of 1st January were returned. Net amount of 1st January purchase was rupees 9,000. Therefore, 9,000 into 10% is equal to 900 will be recovered as a purchase return. Date number 19, goods sold to Haley, 32,400. Half of the goods sold to her return. So, 32,400 divided by 2, otherwise 50 upon 100, 16,200 will be recorded as a sales return on 20th January. The entire goods was purchased from Nirmi. Net amount of a goods purchased from Nirmi was 30,000. Therefore, 30,000 into 50 upon 100, 15,000 recorded as a purchase return. Date number January 31, Kanu returned goods out of transaction of date January 24. Therefore, goods amount of rupees 10,800 into 50 upon 100, otherwise 10,800 divided by 2, means 5,400 is recorded as a sales return and carriage 300 into 50 upon 100 is equal to 150 is recorded in journal proper. Here wages for sales account is debited and Kanu account is credited because this paid wages is paid in cash. So we have to write this in a cash book. This way our illustration number 7 is over. Thank you very much.